created by Gnanmantri Modern School. We have started unit number 7, that is environmental changes, and we are dealing with those pictures, and you are told to write something about those pictures. Three of them we have written and we have discussed. Now it's time to go for picture number 4. So please take your book and see that picture, and I'll write some information about that picture on the board, and you have to write along with me. Please take your book. I'm talking about the picture number 7.4, that is changing climate. We are on page number 39, unit number 7. Now, picture number 5. And this picture is, here we can see the greenery, all the trees and the something like jungle and forest. So here, this kind of situation we can see at the time of after the rain. Means after rain, there will be greenery in all the forest. So, picture 7.4. Picture number 5 is a picture of thick forest area. Generally, this is formed after heavy rain. Sometimes due to heavy rain, destruction of tree happens in the jungle or in the forest. This is also called lush green area of the forest. Lush green means full of greenery. Area full of greenery is called lush green area. So now we'll go for picture number 6. And that picture number 6 is about see what picture number 6 is telling to us. Okay, here we have lot of water and many vehicles are stuck in this water. So we can clearly see that here it is a picture of heavy rain, or we can say it is a picture of flood. So both can be possible. The situation of heavy rain and flood. Here, all the roads are blocked with the water. Can be seen during rainy season. So, see, this kind of scene can be seen during rainy season. Means during rainy season, we find this kind of flood situation. And as you all know that because of that flood, people are not able to come out from their houses, and generally vehicles are stuck in this kind of water clogged situation. Please note down this. After that we will go for climate change or global warming. Students, you might have heard about the global warming word. Means we all use this word in sometimes, or you have heard this word from news or from newspaper or from anywhere else. So exactly what is this global warming, that we will discuss after that. The effect of global warming will be discussed. Global warming refers to an unequal and continual rise in the average temperature of Earth's climate system due to the greenhouse gases. Just because of the greenhouse gases, the changes in temperature, average temperature of Earth's climate system is changed, and that is called global warming. See, unequal and continual rise in the average temperature of Earth's climate system. system. You can remember like this. Due to some greenhouse gases, there is a change, unequal and continual change in Earth's climate system is called global warming. This you can easily be remembered. Due to increasing of UV rays in the atmosphere, this global warming situation is occurred. This effect makes the planet warmer, which subsequently reaches to global warming. Because of this, the climate of planet become warm. 7.5 greenhouse effect and global warming. See, there is a deforestation, there is oil and petrol engines, there is greenhouse gases and fossil fuels, and this is absorbed by atmosphere and earth. And here that is that age of atmosphere is given, absorbed and reflected, and this way this layer of earth becomes warmer. So which kind of thing is responsible for global warming? So first, deforestation. Second, oil and petrol engines, greenhouse gases and fossil fuels, that is called greenhouse effect. So picture tells a lot of thing here. So this is for your information, means which are the factors or factors which are responsible for global warming are deforestation, oil and petrol engines, greenhouse gases and fossil fuels, and CFCs. That are the factor responsible for global warming. Now turn the page number 14. Do it yourself, that is given. Cover yourself with a blanket for 10 minutes. What did you experience? This is what greenhouse effect is. So now what you have to do is, you have to cover yourself with a blanket, in a blanket, for 10 minutes. And after that you have to tell your experience, means what would you what did you experience? How did you feel that? And that is called greenhouse effect. Means increasing of heat just because of these all factors are called greenhouse effect. News from newspaper. Here one news is given from newspaper. Average increase of 5 Celsius in the temperature in West Europe. Heat experienced. 14 Celsius temperature in Darjeeling reaches to maximum of 28 Celsius. It is news of 2009. So in Darjeeling generally it is 14 Celsius temperature, and that is increased to 28. It means almost double. Snowfall in desert. See, can you imagine that snowfall in desert? So because of this climate change, because of this greenhouse effect, there is a snow in desert area. Mumbai received 940 mm rain in one day. That is the news of 2005. Increasing temperature in Australia. That is also the news of 2005. Sundarban is submerging. That is also strange. Reduction of 5 km in Khumbu snow river of Nepal. So river is just reducing. Means river is becoming empty. River is reducing, that is the sign of climate change. Ice cap of the size of 3250 square kilometers melt within 35 days in Antarctica. So Antarctica ice was melting. That is also the sign of a dangerous global warming. Sources of river are drying up. And rivers are drying up. Means there is no water in river. So that this all things are the signs of global warming and global warming and climate change, you notice very strange thing. Means in desert there is a snow, that is almost impossible. Means there is no water even in the desert, and how can snow will be snow was there in the desert? So that is unbelievable thing for us, but that is true. Because of this climate change, because of this global warming, this kind of strange things, strange as well as dangerous thing is happening. So we should keep on eye on this matter, or we should pay attention on this matter. Now, how does the earth get heated? That we will discuss, but you just not done this thing. After that, we will discuss that. How does the earth get heated? So how does this earth get heated? Let's see. The greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, nitrox oxide, chlorofluorocarbon, that is CFC, and halocarbons plays an active role in the greenhouse effect. The increase in the proportion of these gases leads to the problem of global warming and the climate change. So these all gases are the reason for changing the climate and the reason for increasing the problem of global warming. Which are those gases? The greenhouse gases are carbon dioxide, chlorofluorocarbon, that is CFC, and halocarbons. So these are called the greenhouse gases. Now what happened? Proportion of these gases leads to problem of global warming. See, this is the chain of increasing of that global warming. These are greenhouse gases, or very much effective gases or dangerous gases, we can say. If the increment or if the proportion of this kind of grasses is increasing, then that will lead to climate change and that will automatically lead to greenhouse effect, that is very dangerous. Carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbon, that is CFC, and halocarbons, these are called greenhouse gases. Proportion of these gases, if proportion of these gases increase, that will lead to problem of global warming. And what exactly happen in global warming? So the temperature of earth is increasing. It means that the layer of the earth becomes very hot, and that is called the problem of global warming. Please you note down this, after that we'll go further. There is a fixed proportion of these gases in the earth. If this proportion is increased, so that will lead to global warming problem. What do you mean by greenhouse effect? What is global warming? Okay, so these two questions answer you have to write in your homework. We will meet again with new information. Till then, bye. Thank you. We'll be right back.